Now, this one, this is the thing I really hate. Here's Olivia Wilde, who's the actress most famous from being in House. And here she is talking about why she is in favor of abortion. This is one of the more disgusting videos I've ever seen.
This election cycle, I'm thinking a lot about reproductive rights. Everyone's right to plan when they want to have a family. And it's on my mind because I'm literally about to have a baby, like in a minute, to be able to decide exactly how.
Okay, so she says that she's thinking about reproductive rights 1 minute from having a baby. This is about as perverse a notion as I could possibly imagine. That as you're about to have your child, you're thinking, boy, wouldn't it be great if I could still kill this thing? It's really imperative that I be able to still kill this thing. You know, here I am. Look how pregnant I am. There's a baby in here. This is my beautiful child. And I was thinking, maybe I should just kill it. You know, it's really important that women be able to kill it anytime they please. She continues along these lines, not, of course, understanding really what she's saying on a moral level.
How and when and why and where I want to have a baby. And I believe that is a basic human right. I care about reproductive rights. What do you care about? If you care about your future, okay, vote for it.
Okay, what I care about is not killing babies. And this is going to be mildly graphic, but this is important because I'm sick of the euphemisms, okay? It's not aborting a fetus. It's not getting rid of a ball of tissue. Okay, what I'm about to show you right now is a picture of a baby. Okay, this is a baby it was a picture of a baby that was aborted by Kermit Gosnell. Okay, this is the Gosnell was somebody who was not covered by the media in any way, shape, or form. He was the most prolific serial killer probably in American history, and this was a baby girl aborted by Kermit Gosnell, and the only question was whether it was legal for him to kill this baby or not. And the only question there was how old was the baby, and was the abortion done inside the womb or outside the womb? Okay, so this baby, I believe, was after the 24-week cutoff, but not by much. So this baby is let's see how old this baby is. This is a case where an abortion went awry. She went to a hospital, and the baby ended up dying at the hospital. By 24 weeks, most babies born prematurely will survive. This is a late-term abortion, okay? This is what her baby looks like in the womb. We can see that picture again. That's what that baby looks like. This is a less graphic picture of what an abortion looks like, okay? More graphic picture of what abortion looks like involves the snipping off of the crushing of the skull, the sucking out of the brains. It involves, and these are fully formed children. These are fully formed children. I have two beautiful children. The idea that you get to murder a kid. Okay, no one has a right to choose that picture. Go back to the other one. No one has a right to choose this. No one. No one has a right to choose this. You don't have a right to choose this, okay? That's a baby. You don't get to kill it just because it's convenient to you. You don't have a right to say, it's my decision where and when and how to have the baby. That's an individual human being. And if that baby were outside the womb and you stuck a knife through its chest, you'd be charged with first-degree murder. You kill it in the womb, and we call it a human right. That's not a human right because that's a human, and that human doesn't have any rights because you just decided its rights are less important than your right to your own convenience. Despicable. And so we're now going to play a game with the left. Let's play a little game with the left. The game goes like this, okay? Show the other image. The game goes like this. At which point should you be able to kill this baby? Okay, we're going to play a game called When Should You Be Able to Kill This Baby? Because I've been told by people like Hillary Clinton that you're able to kill this baby all the way up to the very end, right? 32 to 30 weeks. Right? And that's when the baby is fully formed. It can be born alive. It is a fully formed human being. I've watched two of them come out of my wife. These are human beings. These are not balls of tissue. These are not clusters of cells. And I'm sick of being told that it's just an abortion. I don't like the euphemisms. It's not a termination of a pregnancy. It's a termination of a human life. Okay? It's a murder of a human being when you're talking about these babies and this idea that you get to choose that. Look, you got to choose a lot of things in life. You don't get to choose another human being's death. That's not something you get to choose. So when is it okay to kill this? When is it okay to kill this? Is it okay to kill this thing at week 14 when the heart is pumping several quarts of blood through the body every day? How about week 15 when the baby has an adult's taste buds? How about month 4 when the bone marrow is beginning to form? How about that? Or how about weeks 9 and 10 when the baby's teeth are already beginning to form? Its fingernails are already beginning to develop. We're talking about 2 months old, right? The baby can turn the head and frown. The baby can hiccup. Is that okay to kill? How about week 4? By the end of the week 4, The kid is already 10,000 times larger than the fertilized eggs was. There's already the beginnings of eyes and legs and hands. There are already brain waves detectable. Mouth and lips are present. Fingernails are forming. How about week 3? By the end of the 3rd week, the kid's backbone and spinal column and nervous system are forming. The liver and kidneys and intestines are beginning to take shape. How about day 22? The heart's already beating with the child's blood, which may be of a different blood type than the mother. So where in here exactly do you think it's okay to murder that kid because you have a personal convenience issue? Where do you think that you're right? And I love the glowing way she presents this. Here I am. I can't be a bad woman because I'm pregnant. I can't hate babies. I mean, here I am. I'm pregnant. Well, if you don't hate babies, or if you're not interested in killing them, then why are you in favor of people being allowed to kill them? Because it's not a matter of a woman's right to choose. A slave owner didn't get to choose to hold slaves. Nazis didn't get to decide which Jews got to live. And don't give me the it's legal, therefore it's okay. Lots of things were legal. Lots of things in human history have been legal that were totally evil. Okay, it is evil to suggest, as Hillary Clinton does, that the minute before a baby is born, you should be able to drag it by the feet out of the mother, except for the head, stick a scissors in there, ram it into the baby's skull, rip the skull open, suck the brains out, crushing it, and then pull it out. Hillary believes that that's something you should be allowed to do. When I talk about stuff I hate, this is a grave sin. It's a blot on the American Republic. It's a blot on the morality of the American people that we treat the killing of the most innocent among us. We treat the killing of these human beings as nothing more than just an issue of convenience and choice and all the rest of it. It's just no more euphemisms. And I wish to God that Mike Pence would have said that instead of citing to the Bible. Okay, I haven't cited the Bible one time because I think the Bible is right, but I don't think the Bible is the important textbook here. I think what's important here is the science. And I think you're talking about the creation of a unique human life on day one, and you can see it, and you can see the growth. And if you're willing to point out to me where it is that this becomes a human as opposed to a ball of tissue, then let's hear it. Let's hear it. I've gotten tweets, by the way. I tweeted this out earlier, and somebody said, well, the brain waves only start at week 20. So how about that? You know, do you think that people who are brain dead are alive? Well, people who are brain dead don't turn into not brain dead 3 weeks later. Would you kill somebody in a coma because they're brain dead, but you know they're not going to be brain dead in 4 weeks, in 10 weeks? Would you do that? Would you pull the plug on them knowing for a full-on fact that if you just wait a few weeks, that person's going to be fully functional again? Would you do that? And it's just, it's truly incredible to me the way that we can blind ourselves to this. I remember when I was at the 2012 DNC, and I went to, you know, it was in Charlotte, and I walked past an exhibit. And it was a picture, it was the anti-abortion crowd, the pro-life crowd. And they were out there with these pictures of aborted babies. And I walked past and I thought what most people from big cities thought. I thought, wow, how gauche. How gauche. I mean, those are ugly pictures. Should I really have to look at that in the public square? That's really ugly. And then I realized that that's probably how people treated pictures of slavery back in the 1850s. That's probably how people treated pictures of the Holocaust back in the 1940s. The bottom line is, if it's that ugly, maybe you should do something about it instead of whining about how ugly it is. And it's not a matter of personal choice. Okay, I have a stake in whether my neighbor gets murdered. And I have a stake in whether my neighbor's baby gets murdered too.